Should we start over?
However you want.
That could possibly be. I'm so sorry.
No, it's really not a big deal. Can we?
It's gonna work.
Just say one.
Go.
What is a person? Well, a body. And a mishmash agglomeration of experiences, emotions, memories, and instincts, all forming some confusing concept called a consciousness that seems to change like Play-Doh, altering its form completely at the slightest of touch.
Some believe we're born a blank slate. Others, we long ago were prescribed our fate. But regardless of your belief, it's clear that we are simply the summation of all we've seen.
Last year, Ecuador and Bolivia published around 3,000 books. The U.S., close to 1 million. Now, to be fair, many U.S. authors are self-deluded coops convinced their stories are worth telling. But the power of a story to change the way the world is viewed, even if it's only for an individual or two, is a positive externality and a new lens through which to view reality. We've learned a lot from the stories we've heard, so here are two of our favorites and what we've observed.
The Name of the Wind by Patrick Rothfuss. A hero of legends, a creature of lore, spins tales of adventure, of laud, and of glory. Now washed up and dried out, the connection is thin between the man of our story and the persona he spins. He once wielded power like a thrice taloned claw. He once tasted truth, once outwitted the law. but he abandoned his name, his allotment of self, and with it, his skill, his pride, and his health. Now merely a shadow, undeserving of fame. I can't help but wonder if the world's done the same. I have always considered myself quite tan, but no place has leached me of color more than Bolivia.
I was white. White as Halloween Town on a blaring TV.
White as the mannequin staring at me.
White as food to American standards.
White as I Love Cali lanyards.
White as the English shirts I passed.
White as skin lining, sure to last.
White as in rich.
White as in power.
White as in hungry with the world to devour.
White enough to get in free, because the only ticket I needed was from the genetic lottery I had won, where millions of others had provided the funds. Why is this the bar? How can one single story stretch so far? Ta-da. I only wish my hands were clean. I ghostwrote this ending when I threw you that ing, when I crowned myself developed and you developing.
But are we the finished product we think? Can our world bear our weight and not start to sink? When bodies embody us and consuming consumes us, can we righteously implore others to move to us? After all, our story, this story, turns people into pillars, into slaves to support the market we've sown. But I know humanity, and cement will never match the strength of bone. Columns collapse, crumble, corrode, sink to their knees and relinquish their load. GDPs plummet, civilizations fall. Stories alone can withstand it all. Bolivia's painted bright with the indigenous population.
Slathered over in white by impeding modernization.
A blank canvas.
A clean slate.
For us to condemn to our own fate.
And I lack nothing in national pride. But I don't think we have to be the winning side. Yet we've started a war.
We may not hold the gun.
But we're the ones keeping score. As our armies toss out alongside our charity, our thirst for dominance swims into clarity. There's a nasty habit we've picked up recently. Of only protecting endangered species. We have a complex where we push the brink of extinction before we finally decide they're worthy of distinction. But I don't want my child to draw a single breath in a world where diversity has succumbed to death. Every story we tell is just a plea to belong, to be part of a country, a culture, a world we long. But instead of widening the borders to include a broader range, we shrink ourselves to fit on the page. So now, more than anything, I want my words to be confessional, instead of tediously composing a recessional, a song to obscure the sound of my steps as I retreat to the shallows to hide from the depths. Now, I want to dust off forgotten truths.
I want to tear through silence's shrouds.
I want to bottle the world's rusty whispers.
And declare them clear and loud.
I want to listen. But I don't know where to lend my ear, when usually my own breathing is all I can hear. Maybe this isn't for me to proclaim. After all, I was the kid who from every birthday 5 to 10 cried because I knew with soul and certainty that with the birth of a new age, another era died, Besides, I've never heard of winter giving passing notice or sheepish call, as it so heartlessly evicted a forlorn and crumbling fall. So I'm sorry. I don't mean to paint with such dark strokes or dark hues, but sometimes I think it's time we choose the stories we want to amberize into history. Unfortunately, my books were always too skilled of cross-dressers to allow me to learn astronomy. Harry Potter, so similar in size, could so easily don a paperback disguise. So my words may not prove overwhelmingly wise, but I hope I've censored fact from fiction when I say galaxies can pass through each other without collision, but never without a state of configuration.
Our encounter mustn't mean damnation.
If only we could pluck up the era of globalization.
Twist it around to a different connotation.
Point it away from colonization.
And let it fly.
If only we could reach a cultural give and take.
Find a world we could both bear to make.
Finally grow for mutuality's sake.
We could look up at the sky.
And draw a constellation spanning here to Mars without sacrificing the brightness of a single star.
Mistborn by Brandon Sanderson. A seemingly weak, inconsequential girl of the streets meets the legend of stories only spoken in murmurs. He awakes from within her, a power held by the elite, and together they overthrow the evil Lord Ruler. But without her mentor, her guide, where would she be? Begging on street corners, trapped by an oppressive regime? So how does one escape the clutches of expectations, except by being taught life-changing revelations? In a small rural Ecuadorian town, there's a school filled with bright-eyed young kids, with dreams of a kingdom and education their crown. To be doctors and lawyers and scholars they aspire, but they don't know a soul to make it past high school. And to even dare to have these dreams, these desires, their society merely smirks and calls them a fool. These kids have been inundated with their place in the world, and it isn't to receive a college diploma. So because they're never shown a way their dreams swirl, but damn it if they couldn't mature like grapes from Sonoma. So think about your favorite book, or at least your favorite tale. Remember its words wrapping themselves around your heart as you imagined yourself alongside the very heroes you hail. I bet you just knew you had to take part. So do you know that first moment of inspiration? That rush of excitement and determination, springing up like a well breaking into an untouched water source deep below the ground, rushing through your fingers and leaving them tingling, flooding your eyes until your eyelids are so wide they might just burst, absorbing every ounce of attention you could possibly manage until your peripherals go blurry, but you've never seen anything so clearly. But what if you were told you are not to take action? What if you're told the protagonists of the world stories are the Tom Cruises and Leo DiCaprios that star in all the stories on TV? What if the people who designed your clothes and set your trends were just white faces speaking a language you can't even understand? You get doctors without access to the latest information because they studied medicine, not English. You get little kids admitting it's fine to be gay in the US because it works that way there, but Ecuadorian gays being sinners seems perfectly fair.
You get my 3-year-old host sister asking to cut her hair short so it grows back blonde and she'll be pretty.
We internalize the messages we're subliminally exposed to so strongly, it can reteach us lessons we should know through and through. Because I'm not ripped, I have a bad body.
I'm not in an Ivy, so my schoolwork is shoddy.
If you're born rich, you've pretty much got free range.
And above all, if you're not white,
don't you dare make a change.